Okay, let us come to question number 8. It says, if I save 2/7 of my salary, what fraction of it I spend? So he saves 2/7. So let us write that down. Question number 8. Fraction saved is 2/7. Now we have to find out the fraction which he spends. So fraction spent will be, you know that the total fraction is equal to 1. So from 1 we'll subtract this fraction 2/7, we will get the fraction which he spends. We can take this as 1/1. So if he saves 2/7 of whatever income he has, that means he has spent 5/7 of the total income. So this is what we have done in exercise 2.2. Let us move on to exercise 2.3. I hope y'all are following it, boys. Now let's come to exercise 2.3. We have question number 1, part 3. It is 5/8/1/6. The question is about division. Okay, let me write that first. We have 5/8/1/6. Here what we'll do is, in order to divide, we have to find out the reciprocal of 1/6. So this will become 5/8 × 6/1. We can cancel this. So ultimately, your answer will be 15/4, and that can be written in mixed fraction as 3/3/4 as the answer. So let's come to question number 2, part 2. Here we have to find out the reciprocal. Now you know that in order to find out the reciprocal of a fraction, 1 has to be divided by that fraction in order to get the reciprocal. So here we have 1/16. Now the reciprocal of 1/16 will be 16/1, or simply 16, because if we divide 1 with this fraction, we'll get the reverse, or the numerator will become the denominator and the denominator will become the numerator. So here 1/16 will become 16/1, or the reciprocal of 1/16 will be simply 16. Similarly, if you want to find out the reciprocal of 5/2, that will be 2/5. If you have 3/5, that will be 5/3. So all these type of sums you can do. Okay, so this is how you find out the reciprocal. If it is 1/16, it becomes 16/1, and if it is 5/3, it becomes 3/5. So this is how you find out the reciprocal. Now let's come to question number 5, straightforward. Yes, let's come to question number 5. Question number 5, we have 3/1/3 of 1/1/5. By 1/5. This is the question we have. I hope you all are following all the problems which we have solved so far. Here this question we have 3/1/3 of 1/1/5 divided by 1/1/3 of 1/1/4. So what you'll do first here, you'll first change them into improper fraction. So this will give you 10 by 3 of 6 by 5, 4 by 3 of 5 by 4. Now let us see what can be cancelled here. You can cancel 3 with 6, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. You can cancel 5 with 10, 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. Here you can cancel 4. So here you get 4 by 1, and here you get 5 by 3. So ultimately, this can be written as 5 by 3 will become 3 by 5. You have to find out the reciprocal of 5 by 3. So ultimately, your answer will be 12 by 5, which can be written as 2 by 5. So what you have done is, first you change it into improper fraction. Then you see which numbers can be cancelled, cancel it, reduce the numbers. You get 4 by 1 by 5 by 3. Now what you have to do is, you have to find out the reciprocal of the denominator. It's a complex fraction here. So you have to find out the reciprocal of the denominator. You get 4 by 1 into 5 by 3 becomes 3 by 5. And ultimately you cancel it, you'll get 2 by 5 as the answer. Now let's come to question number 8. Here you have, how many 1/8s are there in 3 by 4? Let us see. Now suppose if I say, how many 2s are there in 10? What you'll do? You'll simply divide 10 with 2, you'll get 5. There are 5 2s in 10. Similarly, if I ask you, how many 1/8s are there in 3 by 4? What you'll do? You will divide 3 by 4 with 1 by 8. So here, question number 8. In order to find out how many 1/8s are there in 3 by 4, you will simply divide 3 by 4 with 1 by 8. So that means there are 6 1 by 8s in 3 by 4. So that is all in exercise 2.3. I hope you'll be able to do the other problems by yourself if you relate with these problems. Now let's come to exercise 2.4. It is all about simplification. So observe it carefully so that you can understand each and every step which I teach. Here you have exercise 2.4. Let me write down the question. We are taking up question number 1 and 2 are very simple. I hope you can do it yourself. Now I'm taking up question number 3 straightforwardly. Question number 3 part 2. We have 5 minus 1 by 2. So here we have 5 minus, within curly bracket we have 1 by 2 plus, and within circular bracket we have 3 by 4 minus 1 by 2. So first what we'll do is, according to the rule of Bodmus, we will solve the circular bracket. So we'll solve this first. Now before solving it, what we have to do is, we can check here, there is a mixed fraction here. So that has to be first changed into improper fraction. In the next step, we'll solve this bracket. Two will go two times, so two ones are two. 3 minus 2 gives you 1, so you have 1 by 4. Now we'll solve what is there in the curly bracket. We have 3 by 2 plus 1 by 4. The LCM is 4. 2 will go 2 times. 4 will go 1 time. You'll have 5 minus 7 by 4. You can write this as 5 by 1 to make it look like a fraction. The LCM will be 4. 1 will go 4 times. 4 5s are 20. 4 will go 1 time in 4. 1 into 7 is 7. Ultimately, your answer will be 13 by 4, and which can be written in mixed fraction as 3 1 by 4. So this is how you will solve it. First, you will change this term or this fraction into improper fraction, and then you will solve what is there in the circular bracket first. Then after you solve it, you see, you remove the bracket. You get 1 by 4 here, you solve the circular bracket, and once you solve it, you remove the bracket, and then you solve the curly bracket, and once you solve that, you remove that curly bracket, and then proceed on to get the ultimate answer. So this is how you will, this is the step you will follow to solve these kinds of problem. Let us come to question number 4, part